Hello everyone, welcome to a special Let's Play of I Love You, Colonel Sanders, a finger-licking good dating simulator.
Woo! Woo! I'm ready to get finger-licking good with some chicken.
We're going to get finger-licking.
We are going to get finger-licking.
Excellent. Yes, this is a special Valentine's special.
Because you can have Valentine's, you can have Galentine's, but we're having chicken time.
Chilling chicken times?
Yeah, chicken time. Yeah.
Palentine's?
We are the best of pals. Ooh, wee.
Excellent. Let's get into it then. Ooh.
We get to pick a name. Oh my goodness. Shall we?
Put William, or what were you going to suggest?
Oh no, I was just going to go with a jade or a frog, but Willy-Ann's.
Like Willy-Ann's?
Willy-Ann's. But I think it looks better with Ann's.
Okay, put Ann's in.
Cool, Willy-Ann's. Alright, oh. Look at all that chicken!
Chicken and scones.
Oh, is it scones or is it scones?
I don't know.
Right.
Sleep softly as the morning sun casts a warm glow through the window of your modest student apartment. The world is peaceful and serene. You could stay in the moment forever. I can dig that.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can wake up now. Your first day of culinary school is no time to sleep in.
Oh, that'll do me in. Oh, it's
smack
going
that
forever.
Clock.
Smack that it.
Clock. Lying in bed, you stare at the ceiling, thinking about everything that awaits you at the prestigious University of Cooking School Academy of Learning. For learning, God, I'm good at reading. Your mind begins to wander.
Oh.
Who will be there? What will you cook? What should you wear? Time begins to fly by and you find your imagination getting away from you. I'm going to daydream.
Classic like William.
It's finally here, your first day of culinary school. So many dishes to prepare. So many students to meet. Your mind is swimming with possibilities when you realize you're running late.
Oh,
you
no.
grab a biscuit and burst out the door in a hurry. Biscuity goodness. Delicious. Just when you need to wake up those taste buds. Yikes, you're in such a hurry, in fact, that you forgot to put on any deodorant.
Ew.
You're sweating buckets as you rush to arrive on time.
You stinky.
I'm a stanky boy. Stanky chicken boy. Standing in the quad, you gaze upon the magnificent University of Cooking School. That's weird.
Yeah, it's not the best translation.
Oh, here comes your lifelong best friend forever, Miriam. She's the most adorably awkward person you've ever met. You absolutely love her for it.
I identify.
I know someone like that, yeah. Good morning, Willy-Ann's.
I could do it if you want.
All right, you do Miriam. Go on.
Good morning, Willy-Ann's. Are you excited for your first day of the rest of our lives?
Actually, I'm...
Because I sure am excited, a little nervous. Okay, a lot nervous.
What's the...
It's just that this morning I made breakfast for myself, but well, when I ate it, I couldn't taste any love in the food. What if I'm not good? What if I fail?
Classic Miriam. Raised by a master chef parents, she's always held to herself to a very high standard.
Look at them no little teardrops in her eyes.
She's still got the stance going on.
Yeah, she's like doing kung fu.
Ever since we were little babies playing together, you rescued me from that quicksand box. And it's clear to me that you're the most loving, caring person I know. You're going to do great.
Great. I'm getting some Kellogg's in there. But with the University of Cooking School, Academia for Learning. Oh, it's Academy. No.
Academia.
Academia. Academy for Learning, famous 3-day only semesters. I'm afraid of being left out and never catching up.
A sweet girl, Miriam, has always had a flair for the dramatic. This summer, she got so nervous about her first kiss that she chipped a tooth practicing on a mannequin.
Jesus, she's so stressed right now.
That is weird. Should you pep talk her or change the subject to give her some reason? Pep talk that bitch.
Yeah, help me out, bro.
Remember last month when we saw that fortune teller and had our tarot cards read?
Ooh, the lady with the mask who gave me nightmares? I've been trying to forget.
I know she looks spooky, but she was so sweet, and she told you that you were destined for great things. Remember that card with the fancy-looking tower?
Oh, no.
And the other card featuring the handsome fellow in the red suit?
It's not a good sign. I've been waiting for so long to meet a handsome fellow I could call my own.
And I'm sure you will soon. In no time, we'll be graduating, and you'll be delighting the world with your heartfelt cooking in no time at all.
Aww.
As you talk Miriam up, you can hear her. You feel her nerves begin to ease.
You're such a good friend. Yeah. You know what? Maybe everything will be A-okay after that, and if not, at least I have these killer bags? Oh, hair. Got it. Fringe. Yeah. Can you believe I cut them myself? Oh, no.
You can definitely believe it. Oh, harsh.
I cannot believe it.
Before you get another word out, you're rudely interrupted when someone smacks your books and custom engraved measuring spoons out of your hands onto the ground.
No! Hey! Oh.
Oh,
mommy.
It's Ashley?
Oh,
your
God.
Arch rival.
Just call her Ashley.
Ashley, she's totally evil, but you can't help but be filled with jealousy. She can get away with anything she wants, and she knows it.
Oh.
Hello, Ashley.
I guess I'll do females, you do males. Because there's one fabulous male I know I definitely want you to be doing.
Okay.
Oh, I didn't see the chicken shins. You leave William's shins alone. They are perfectly normal shins.
Ugh, you can't stand Ashley. Even though her name is annoying, it is. You know her for a fact that she isn't. She's actually Ashley, but she had to add extra letters to make her feel better than everyone else. Holy shit.
Look at her thick thighs, though.
She is thick, for sure.
If anyone here knows what perfect shins look like, it's us.
We're not gonna let you or your really weird insults get to us.
Across the quad, you see Ashley's best friend, Van the Man, has stopped to look at his own reflection in the mirror. His pants are so tight, you can see him casually working out his glutes just while he styles his hair. No lie, they're rocking glutes. Oh,
he's great.
Goodness.
You're gonna love him. Van. Here you go.
Rang.
He's not inspired by JoJo Bizarre at all.
I was
going to
say, that's some JoJo's right there. He's even got the hair. What is
that? It's amazing.
Oh, you've never been sure what their arrangement is, but as long as you've known them, Ashley and Van have been just as close as you and Miriam, but substantially more devious.
Look at them. Side titty and everything.
I can't believe the University of Cooking School Academy for Learning would allow people like you to attend as students.
I know, right? You'd think they'd just hand us our diplomas now.
Or maybe hires one of us professors. You amateurs could learn a lot from us. With the first day of school about to start, there's just not time to properly tell these two off. So you resist the urge.
Oh, resisting.
Let's go, Miriam.
Psh, see you later, looters.
As you approach the door, you see a goofy-looking kid pushing hard against the window and directly next to it.
Oh, look at his little toofy.
Pop.
Oopsie. I think it's broken.
You reach forward and easily pull the door open.
That should do the trick. I love you. I think you mean thank you. My name is Pop. I was named after my pop. He's old.
I'm fucking dying.
I'm just dedicated to this now. Fuck it.
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
Could someone like this also be a student at the school? He must be one heck of a chef. There's also his name tag. Clearly says Bob, but I guess he's reading it upside down.
Oh,
fucking
no.
Hell. Yeah, of course.
Is he old enough to be here?
His hat as well.
Hi, Pop. I'm Willian, so... Are you gonna make me hold this door all day?
Hold the little ghostie.
No!
And with that, the young man walks into the building ahead of you.
Is it just me or is he kind of cute?
I think it's just you.
Bro, shrug your shoulders before following him into the building.
I think Miriam's eyes need testing.
Her fucking poses each time.
Like, yeah, she's like, ta-da!
You stand at the edge of the room, unsure where to sit. Other students wander in and keep themselves busy chit-chatting.
The teacher is the best.
A scruffy-looking pooch takes his place at the podium at the front of the class. Adorable. His snoot is so sure. Wow, it looks really funny.
He's got to be able to get right in there.
This is the teacher, is it?
Yep.
Do you want to be the teacher?
Okay. What does a dog sound like? Sprinkles. No, quiet, everyone.
Who's this unreasonably cute pup, and why is he in our culinary class?
You must be Sprinkles, head instructor and CEO of UCSAL. Please call me Professor Dog. I may be cute and little and fluffy, but I still demand respect. Woof!
What a cute dog is our professor. This is the best school ever! I guess only a dog's nose is capable of picking up all the nuances of fine dining.
Exactly.
Out of nowhere, wind begins to rush all around you as a swirl of cherry blossom petals fill the air inside the classroom.
Anime!
It's so magical.
It's so
magical. I'm chilly. Someone close the window.
Someone pop the window.
Someone pop that window.
And then he walks in.
Look at him.
That's the sexiest colonel I've ever seen. Right.
Look how big them hands are.
All the better for rubbing chicken.
Mm-hmm.
You're immediately swept up in the aura of this new student. He's a student? What?
Uh-huh. It's we get a student with we get a class with him before he makes KFC.
Oh, I see. And his remarkable goatee. Who knew anyone could be so handsome? Time stands still.
Oh, it's him! If it isn't my favorite student, Harland.
Colonel Sanders interrupts Sprinkles. Sorry, Professor Dog, before he can finish his sentence.
Oh, Hugh.
Please call me Colonel. Colonel Sanders.
I'm blushing.
A hushed murmur rolls through the classroom as Colonel Sanders walks down the aisle of desks. Suddenly, the room is sweltering.
I'm sweltering.
Oh, yeah. Whew. Sweat begins to bead across your brow. You feel like everyone is looking at you, and you're not entirely wrong.
And this over here must be sweaty, sweat a lot.
Maybe we should open that window back up before Faucet Pit melts into a puddle and evaporates entirely.
Hold on just a second, Nobby talks to my friend like that.
You two both know my name. We were in the same kindergarten class. And what is with all your really weird insults?
Besides, when William sweats, it's not gross, it's beautiful. Look at that shimmer!
Colonel Sanders, beautiful angel that he is, stands before you, smiling gently, his hand outstretched. Boy, howdy, this classroom gets hotter than a Kentucky fryer. Please, use my handkerchief.
Look at them biceps.
Oh, he's just tonk. Freeze up. Colonel Sanders is talking to you.
Oh my god.
The master of chicken is here. He's talking to me. Rim him. I want to rim him now.
Now.
Wait, Colonel Sanders is talking to you? About how sweaty you look. You're completely mortified.
But he's blowing you kisses, so it's fine.
This can't be your first interaction. What if he never forgets this moment? How will you respond? Oh, I take that. I take it straight away.
Take it.
You stretch out your hand and Colonel Sanders places a fine silk handkerchief in it. Oh, of course he does. It's so beautiful you hesitate to press it to your face, but when you do, the feeling is transcendent. It has a natural scent on it. It smells of the most delicious chicken you've ever smelled. I would actually love that, though. That's the problem.
What, a chicken napkin?
just chicken and the perfume that you were showing me.
Oh, yes. Yeah, so last year, there's a KFC perfume that they released through their app. That was the only way you could buy it.
I would love that. I really would. Chicken.
Odie chicken. It doesn't smell like chicken, sadly, though.
Aww. Professor Dog. Sorry, go on.
No, go, it's fine.
Professor Dog steps in to settle the class down and get some ground rules.
Welcome to University of Cooking School, Academy for Learning, the greatest culinary academy in the world, the birthplace of culinary legend past, present, and future. Many challenges await you. There will be tears, there will be blood. There might even be really adorable, tiny food. And when all is said and done, there will be a battle. You will lift your sporks and compete in the broom cooking arena.
Amazing. Just then, another student enters the classroom and interrupts the professor's rousing speech.
Rude. Oh.
Hi guys, sorry I'm late. I hope everyone had a good summer. I really miss.
Quiet!
His face.
Late to class is bad enough, but interrupting my monologue? You're on the fast track out of here, young man. Are you sure you're even in the right place?
Don't you recognize me? This is my third year in this school. It's you as my teacher.
I feel like I've heard this kid before.
Everyone stares at him blankly.
Does no one remember me? I'm...
You're expelled if you utter one more word before I finish.
those drawings are great.
So act like an angry boy. Let that be a lesson to you students that tidiness is unacceptable. Even Clank made it here on time, rolling halfway across town on his tiny wheels.
You turn to see the student Sprinkles is referencing, who appears to be some sort of industrial kitchen appliance, for fuck's sake. Bzz.
Lol, bless.
Class bursts into laughter. He's got a little hat. Oh, he's a pressure cooker. Amazing.
I was going to say, what is he?
Yeah, he's a pressure cooker. That's so good.
Oh, Clank, you rascal.
Sprinkles walks in the classroom as everyone stands in silent obedience. When he gets to you, he lifts his nose in the air and takes a deep sniff.
Your diet is lacking based on what I'm picking up here. You'll definitely need a multivitamin. You should be taking better care of yourself.
Well, how does he know? How does he know? He's smelling me through the screen.
Fuck!
Bastard. You've never had a talking dog as a teacher before, but Sprinkles' reputation for being smart and tough is well known.
Oh.
You decide to try and butter him up by giving him a treat from your pocket. But what kind? Ooh.
Chicken.
Oh, you reckon? You reckon it's chicken?
Well, it's a chicken game.
It might be too obvious, though.
Well, that's true. It's true. I'm voting chicken.
All right, we'll go chicken. We'll go chicken. Okay. You reach beneath your apron and return with a chicken snack in your hand. Sprinkle's eyes go wide as he locks onto it. His favorite. Wow. Oh. Okay. It was too obvious.
Yeah, that's how we play these games. Well. I think there might be some competition for our new star student.
The furry professor immediately devours the snack, leaving your hand slick with a coating of warm doggy drool.
My favorite.
You see the other students eyeing you jealously, but pay them no mind. If they wanted to succeed in life, they should have learned the importance of carrying on a range of dog treat flavors on them at all times.
Yeah, that's what you should always do, whether you have a dog or not. Always have dog treats on you.
That is a good life lesson. Yeah.
Settle down, young chefs. Take your seats and prepare to have your minds opened to the amazing possibilities of culinary creations.
As everyone rushes to claim their favourite seats, you're left standing at the front of the room. Only two options remain.
Hey, William, there's a seat here.
It seems no one has claimed this seat next to me, if you're interested.
Are we going?
I feel like I would be betraying Miriam so hard, though.
Yeah, but it's do you want some chicken or do you want a friend?
I gotta sit by the best friend. I can't deny. It's the first day. We're lifelong best friends. That would be too mean.
Fair.
Too mean. Even in a game, I can't.
I betray that bitch for old man.
You move to take your seat by Miriam.
I'm so glad to have you near me to support me through this class.
Of course. Oh yeah, sorry. Of course, you're my best friend. Who else would I sit by?
Anime protagonist. Enter. Colonel Sanders, he has such a magnetic personality, and there's a seat open right next to him. If you'd sat there, you might have got to know him a little better.
I'd never sacrifice our friendship. Besides, I'm sure I'll get the chance to talk to him later in the semester. I've got 3 whole days. That's like a lifetime.
So long.
So you say. But now that Miriam mentions it, that Colonel Sanders is just so darn dreamy. As soon as you've settled into your seat, the professor makes an announcement.
Ooh. Think fast. It's time for a pop quiz.
Oh, God.
Are you ready?
Not a pop quiz.
You'll be good at them. It's food related. You'll be good at it.
Yay, a quiz about me.
Oh, God. This incredibly important and surprisingly short quiz will tell me if you are ready for life at culinary school. Keep your knives sharp and your focus sharper. Here comes question one. If train A is travelling to point B, and train B is travelling to point A, how important is it to wash your hands before cooking?
Extremely. Looking at you, Pop. You must always wash your hands. That's right.
Forest is to tree as chicken is to...
Feathers, I presume. Night vision goggles, fuck's sake.
But bro, I was really confused by that. I was like, huh?
Wait a minute. That's right.
Yeah, ding, 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 ding. What is the most efficient eating utensil ever created?
Well, he mentioned spork earlier, so yeah, I think it's going to have to be a spork.
I would love to see a comically oversized fork, though. That'd be great.
Yeah, just whip it out. That's right.
Yeah, oh, so you're so good at this. Oh, there's one more. What food is best for a broken heart?
Fucking camel meat, fuck's sake. Probably the top. It's either the top or the bottom one, but probably the top one.
Yeah, as I say, my personal thing would be pancakes, because that's amazing. But yeah, with love.
I didn't eat any pancakes yesterday. I always do this on pancake day.
It's because you can have pancakes all year round. Stop it for one day.
Exactly. We had pancakes. Pop-Tarts instead.
Ah, see, that's great. That's a good option. We had pancakes. It was great.
Ah, free!
But we also had pancakes Monday and Sunday, so, you know.
Dang.
Ding, 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 ding!
That's right!
Oh! Is Sprinkles a good boy?
Oh, well, it's obviously the middle one. That's right.
Your total score is...
Oh, ba-ba-ba! Perfect. 5 out of 5.
So proud of you.
Hell yeah. Oh, I'm so smart.
So smart.
I'm smart. Wow. Be honest. Did you cheat? You look up to see that the colonel has been watching your score. He's impressed.
Ooh, getting in.
I know we just met, but I have something to confess. I think you have a beautiful brain.
Did you see all the little parts that came out of him?
Hot diggity Williams, you just scored some major Colonel Sanders points with that performance. Oof.
May, I have your attention, students. I have an important announcement to make. Time for lunch!
Wow. The cafeteria is as nice as any restaurant you've ever eaten at. It makes the sense that the school dedicated to cooking would also be serious about eating.
Ah, it's better than any cafeteria I've ever had.
Yeah, true. Your delicious, I suppose your delicious fragrance.
Oh, thanks.
Delicious fragrance. Wafts through the room and tickles the end of your nose. Your mouth waters. Is it chicken?
I hope it's chicken. Do you smell that? That must be our lunch. It smells crazy good.
Everyone, can I have your attention? I don't know why I'm doing like a special voice.
It's because his voice looks like it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Is it about lunch?
No, I just wanted to apologize for my tardiness. You see, I was...
Howdy, folks. I'd like to make an announcement.
Hi, I was...
It's about lunch. What a dick. Everyone cheers.
But I...
Shh! Lunch, lunch, lunch. She said shush.
In honor of the new semester, I prepared something special to share with everyone for lunch.
Uh-oh.
My asshole.
That must be the smell I smelled.
Indeed, that smell.
Look at his figure, man.
His posture. The poses.
Oh.
Those forearms.
I might.
You hold your breath, waiting to see what food this mysterious student has created. You've heard that he's very talented. Mm-hmm. But were the rumors true?
With those big hands, they better be.
Is this...
Colonel
Sanders lifts a large bucket over his head. The contents glimmer in the light. Oh,
look at the bucket.
I'm gonna be ordering KFC after this. It's gonna be bad.
Yeah, yeah. Say it's Valentine's Day, Valentine's chicken.
Yeah, love myself with chicken.
Yeah.
Piled high are huge pieces of chicken, breaded and fried to a crispy golden finish. Mm. The aroma envelops you and you begin to feel warm and safe.
I feel so happy.
Oh, Colonel Sanders has filled a bucket with chicken. What a novel concept. Your stomach begins to grumble as if to say, stop thinking and start eating. For years, I have been developing a secret recipe for the perfect fried chicken. By my calculation, nothing less than 11 herbs and spices are required to achieve the perfect balance of flavors.
11. Right, now we've got to start working out which ones it is.
I need the herbs. Tell me the herbs. Does this game reveal it? Is that what you get if you seduce him?
Oh, I don't know.
Don't know. You never seduced him.
No.
You look around and notice that every other student has a pen and paper and scribbling notes as fast as they can. But that's all I'll say about that.
He's blushed! I skipped it, but he blushed!
Oh. You think we want your stupid recipe, dude?
Pishaw!
Nah, my dude. Nah. Wow, it's just nice.
I love him.
I'm just, drafting a last will and testament in case one of those ingredients is, poison. Got him! He looks around nervously to see if anyone else is laughing at his sick burn.
I've got his face now!
He's like,
chicken.
You wait to see what Zinger Ashley has prepared to follow up, but she suddenly takes a different approach.
Yeah, and I was just like writing in my diary. Dear diary, today I smelled something beautiful, and near that moment that only the hands of a true gentleman could fry chicken so tender.
Wow, what a fucking simp.
She's a slut!
Slut lady. You see her body language change from bitter and evil to sweet and innocent as she slides closer to Colonel Sanders. She realizes that he is destined for greatness and fame with cooking skills like this. She wants him all to herself.
I feel you, girl. I'll be playing the same game.
The chicken, playing that chicken game.
Yeah.
Oh, please.
It's the way to a girl's heart.
Well, Van Van, the man, if you don't want any.
I'll take his.
Whoa, hold on. I mean, I guess I'll try it. Takes one bite and his eyes grow wide. He starts contorting his face and he tries to hold on his pure exhilaration and act unimpressed.
He's got all Dragon Ball Z face now.
His pupils completely disappear. The chicken is so good.
Ah!
Easy now. There's enough for everyone. Please follow my fellow classmates. Dig in. I feel like I should probably do some sort of like Southern Texas-y Kentucky accent, but it's a bit late for that now.
I like his voice. He's grand.
You don't want me to do some sort of thing like that.
No, that puts me straight off.
You take one of the pieces of fried chicken out of this bucket and sink your teeth into it. It's amazing.
Dun dun dun. Whoa. Oh,
I was going to say, tasting Colonel Sanders' food transports you into another nation and opens up a black hole. Alone with your taste buds, gripping a drumstick in your hand as you float weightlessly. Ooh, what shall we do? I want to swim towards the light.
I'd try and identify every flavor, but we're swimming towards that light.
Everything that tells you about it. Yeah, I want to swim towards the light. Somewhere up ahead, a bright light beckons you. The flavors are so intense that you become wrapped up in them. Unable to resist, you reach toward the light. It grabs your hand and pulls you closer. Closer.
How close are you?
Until your fingertip connects with the end of everything.
Everything. Shit.
You are forever lost in the land of tender fried chicken bliss. Your mind dissolves. There's no Willy Ann's in you now. There's only herbs and spices. That's going to be me later on. Though Miriam tries to revive you, she cannot.
Oh, no.
Game over, man. What?
Try again. You lost.
Is that what? Is that us actually losing?
Rubber.
What? That's fucking bullshit.
Right, hold on. We can fast
forward.
You
actually get defeated. I didn't know you could even lose. I don't play these kind of games.
We can lose. We cannot fall in love.
So what? Do we have to not fall in love with Chicken Man, or?
We want him to fall in love with us.
Oh, and not get defeated by the chicken.
But we don't want to get too distracted, because if we just fall in love with his food, we won't become a better chef.
What a load of shit.
I'm sorry.
Fine, the middle one. Actually, no, the top one, because that's what you wanted.
Okay.
Yeah. You let the food rest in your mouth and focus on it, scrutinizing every flavor.
Salt, maybe. Pepper, too obvious. Oregano, basil.
Spam deeper into the sea of flavors, but this revelation alone is more than you can handle. You snap out of it and realize this information is from. Now you know, a mantle of responsibility now rests upon your shoulders.
We can blackmail him!
Yes! Yes!
Force it upon him!
Yes. As you look around, you realize that everyone in the room is consumed by the lunch. No one has noticed you've traveled through space and time. After tasting his food, you try to get some one-on-one time with Colonel Sanders.
Oh.
Approach! Colonel Sanders smiles ever so softly as you approach. He stops what he is doing and allows you to break the silence.
Colonel, I wondered if I could talk to you for a second.
Anything for our fellow chef.
What exactly was on that chicken?
Sweat.
How bold to come out and ask. It's an idea I've had for a new combination. Big deal. That staff he's got.
I was gonna say, I want that staff. Little Jamaican.
Talking, I can keep a secret. In fact, I've got some of my own that I'd be willing to trade.
Oh.
What's the rush? The semester's only getting started. We've got 2 more whole days to get to know each other. Yeah, he looks disgusted.
I know.
He's clearly not giving up too easily, but it doesn't hurt to be persistent. Ha ha.
Ha 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 ha.
You know what they say about secrets, Colonel? Shouldn't learning be fun?
You've got moxie, I'll give you that. Colonel Sanders looks both ways to make sure... Whale piss. Just one ingredient, but you can't tell. I use blank, redacted. It's something my great-grandmother taught me.
Oh.
Blank? Wow, you'd never have guessed that. In fact, you're not even sure where you'd get some of that if you search.
I keep trying to click here to see if it'll reveal it, but it doesn't.
And blank definitely isn't the flavor you've tasted before. So now you're 2 ingredients close to knowing the full recipe. But you don't tell Colonel Sanders that. While you're wrapped up in the huge revelation, you notice that Colonel Sanders has disappeared, just magically.
Mm.
While everyone else is still in the cafeteria, you decide to look for him. Let's go find that asshole.
Dun 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 dun!
Side.
Quad. Oh,
the quad, hey. It's you again, ha- Sometimes I
yes.
Look at the school buildings and think about how my story will continue after I've graduated.
It sounds like you have big plans.
I dare say the biggest. I will leave my mark on this world, you can bet on that.
He's crying.
He's doing his pose again. That's the chicken pose. I'm going to do that whenever I cook chicken now.
Yes, that's what gives it the extra zhuzh.
The zhuzh. No, yeah. That's MSG.
Who doesn't love that though?
Everyone loves MSG.
Mm-hmm.
Alone together for the first time, you figure now is the perfect moment to show him your personality.
Hmm.
Neg him. additional ingredient to... Nah, he won't like that.
Hot!
He liked it. Enjoyed your food.
Well...
Now got his attention.
The flavors were complex, but comforting. The interplay between salty, savory, and peppery. It was perfect.
I appreciate the compliment,
Williams. I'm sure you'll be a big success.
I know we've only met today, but I'm starting to get the same feeling about you.
Gwen!
We should head back inside. The next lesson starts soon.
Oh!
Oh, look at arena where the afternoon lesson will each student gets an tools and ingredients they could need.
Look at this place, it's magnificent! Finally we get to show off our stuff. Wait a second. Oh no, we have to show off our stuff. What if I totally blow it?
You're not gonna blow anything except maybe kisses to the crowd of fans you'll earn with your signature adorable tiny food creations.
She makes tiny food. Welcome, students, to the cooking arena.
He'll take that little podium around with him everywhere.
I love him. It's got a little chicken on it.
Yeah.
is. Hurry up and pair off.
Naturally, Miriam looks over at you, but unable to control yourself, you pounce on Colonel Sanders. Don't even get a choice.
Hey, Colonel, would you like to tackle this lesson as a team? Team of two? That is, me and you, if that wasn't clear.
Look at her sad little eyes.
Aww. Wanna be my partner?
Aww. Sure, Williams. I'll prepare our station. Oh, we betrayed her.
It's all right.
Without you.
You didn't get a choice in it, like you said. So it's That's fine.
That's true. She looks pissed off. She's going to cast a spell. You can see it.
She's going to curse us.
Yeah. Chickenus, bickenus. Remove your dickenus. Yeah. Without you as a partner.
Beep boop.
Oh, pit clank, Miriam. Pit clank. Oh my, two potential partners. I'm so sorry, gentlemen, but I don't know who to choose.
It's looked like you'll have to pick for her. Friend duties can be a little awkward, but that's the price you pay for not being alone forever.
What the fuck? What?
Yes, we'll pay that price. If you want to ask to be Miriam's partner.
Clank. Clank. Yeah, for sure.
Clank. All day.
Sorry, Pop, but I think Miriam will be partnering with Clank today. It's okay. I already ate.
What? He makes no sense.
It's not entirely clear if Pop has any... Have some attention. He heats up and begins to roll back and forth.
Warp, warp, warp.
Hold on there, fella. We don't even know the assignment yet.
Technically, Clank might not have a face, but there's something charming and earnest about him.
Aww. Bzzz. His little face is smiling. He's so happy.
That fucking shirt he's got on.
Tissue, I hardly know you.
Clank judders as a panel shakes loose. You get the impression that this is a sign of affection. Oh, she's going to get with it.
It's better than Pop, though. Pop is like a legit child.
Yeah.
Looks like you two will be fine.
Now it's time to focus on our own cooking classwork.
All right, you two, for today's... Head up the steps. No chef is... To make a fire. You get the idea.
Takes two flints to make a fire. I've never heard that before.
Same.
Which dish do you suggest for your partner, Colonel Sanders?
Oh.
Oh, it's mashed potato and gravy. He's be all up in that shit.
Yeah, I was like, oh, steak. Then I was like, oh, mashed potato.
It's steak tartare, though. No one likes that.
What's that? I don't know.
It's raw steak, like
just
raw, like kind of minced up and mashed, pushed together.
Oh no! He did the hearts. You were correct. I saw the hearts.
Yeah. Call some correct. I know my chicken.
I've always been something of a down home chef.
What
me? I was thinking we could make something warm, inviting, comforting. Ada.
Gravy?
I couldn't imagine one without the other.
Colonel Sanders casts a coy look at you, causing your whole face to go beet red. Embarrassed, you quickly turn away.
Oh.
I'll go get the potatoes!
No, please, let me. Picking perfect produce is a passion of mine. Oh, the alliteration. Ooh, oh, delicious.
Looks like things are getting pretty fresh around here. Does someone have a crush on Colonel Sanders?
We're just cooking partners. Mind your own business, you whore.
Sanders' heart is my business, and you better keep your fingers off my man.
Did someone call for me?
Oh, the battle music. Ugh, no cheese, Van Van. You're supposed to be taking care of member.
Oh.
I want to get into this. Yeah,
this
bitch.
Is music. It's sick. Colonel Sanders returns, arms full of peeled potatoes. He tosses them into a boiling water and turns his attention to you and your friends. Oh, howdy there, Ashley, Van. Are we working in a quartet instead of a duet now?
Actually, no. It looked like Williams was struggling, so we offered to give them a hand. You know how it is. These young amateur chefs need a lot of mentoring.
I was going to say, Colonel Sanders, maybe I could also teach you a thing or two about fancy food. Maybe one day you might be able to get up to my level. Ha! Doubt it.
Don't be rude, Van. Personally, I have no doubts whatsoever about Colonel Sanders. To create worthy of admiration, after all, your fried chicken was quite spectacular. But Colonel, if you ask me, I might make a better partner for you than this thing that has positioned itself at your station.
Holy shit.
Don't you feel deep down that we cast complementary shadows? We fit together like a thigh and a drumstick and just makes sense.
Nothing about this makes any sense, which is true. But one thing is clear, she's coming for Colonel. If you don't watch out.
Oh, with them thighs.
Grab a knife and stab her in the face about 600 times. Ashley is really going to be going at you hard, but you need to ask for some backup here before things get ugly.
I fucking really look like jam into.
Yeah, this battle music is intense. What should we do? Ooh. What should we do? Ooh. I feel like the top one is the correct one, although I don't know.
I feel like Bestie might be upset with us right now. So I think we should just let him choose what he wants.
Yeah. I'm here to learn and express myself via my cuisine, not to bicker with a prima donna.
Ooh-hoo-hoo.
Partners were chosen at the beginning of class, so let's respect the format, okay? He turned to Colonel Sanders to confirm that you're on the same page. I chose Colonel Sanders, and Colonel Sanders chose me, isn't that right?
Oh.
A businessman respects all fair agreements, from contract. Based on your team's behavior, I'd say you're perfect. Neither of you has William's natural talent. Defended, not defeated. Yeah, I was gonna say. Wait a minute.
Wait.
I'm just borrowing a bit of your dyslexia. It's fine.
Woo! I'm sharing the magic today.
You look for sprinkles. In hopes that he might step in, but he's nowhere to be found. Darn those cute corgis and their short but sturdy stature.
Always looking around for pets.
Yeah. You look down at your station and realize in the tension of the moment, your hands have been cooking on autopilot.
Oh.
What? Distracted by the drama, you've already crushed the boiled potatoes into a perfect cream for flavor. It's as if your natural passion guided you through the steps you know as well as while your attention was somewhere else.
It's probably been really good when you was getting really angry with her being a prima donna. You're just smashing the potatoes out like, just fuck you, bitch!
You bitch, shut up!
I know just what to do. Colonel Sanders extends his hand. He's holding a beautiful white porcelain gravy boat, out of which pours a smooth brown gravy, smothering your nearly finished potato dish.
See, I'm a big fan of cheesy potato mash as well.
Cheesy potato mash, yes. That's a good one. Oh, look at that.
Oh, now I want gravy. Some mashed potato, man.
Close down the mound of mashed potatoes.
The result looks spectacular. Granny would be proud.
Granny is proud.
just holds a spork out to you. You reach out and grab hold of it, but he doesn't immediately let go. The two of you stand, holding the same spork, and for that small moment, all of the madness and pressure in this crazy world stops.
Oh, I'm dribbling a little bit.
Your eyes lock. The moment is electric and time stands still. If you love something, set it free.
Wait, you're breaking up with me? Don't break up with me. I didn't even know we were together.
Are we setting the potatoes free? With our mouths?
Catch your potato in my mouth.
Together you dig the utensil into the mashed potatoes and lift a heaping sporkful up. When you see Ashley with a sinister look, you know she's plotting against you to be with Colonel Sanders.
Oh, you can't. I've smashed his face now, buddy.
With rage, and without thinking, you fling the sporkful of mashed potatoes right into Ashley's stupid, beautiful face.
Oh. Van Van, do something, do something!
Scooping up a fingerful, Van Van tastes the dripping mashed potatoes and gravy and realizes it's delicious. Horrified by this revelation, he slinks away. Will he ever be able to cook something with so much love and integrity?
Love! Hold on right there, Williams. We do not waste food in this broom cooking arena. Colonel Sanders, I expected better from you. If you throw one more spoonful, you both better be prepared to eat it from wherever it lands.
Can I have... Can I have potatoes face?
Makes no sense.
Van Van rushes back over, a covered dish in his hand.
Oh, he wants Colonel Sanders to lick his hands.
In just a few minutes, I've prepared a full meal. Gaze upon my speciality, braised tentacle of octopus in my silky saltwater sauce, plated in a battle axe forged by my supreme chef ancestors.
That's some hentai shit right there.
Yeah, holy shit. You've ignored me for too long, and hence now, it is I who will have the first bite, and you will look upon me with envy.
Oh my goodness.
Interrupting student rushes at Van Van and swipes a bite of his signature dish right off the plate.
Oh, but is he going to cut himself on the blade?
Yeah.
No, don't! Something about that dish doesn't strive my nose quite right. I think the octopus was rushed and may have turned in the process. The result could be toxic.
Too late. It has been eaten!
I don't feel so good.
Oh. It killed him!
he looks better as a ghost, to be fair.
He does, but it just straight up killed him. What the fuck?
Everyone, step back! Don't take another bite!
When you look back at the plate, the rest of it's gone. You notice the tip of the tentacle is being slurped up in Pop's mouth.
No, not Pop.
Good.
He'll be fine.
Pop winces in pain for just a moment, then is almost immediately back to his oblivious self.
So
he's going to be the underdog here. He's going to win this whole thing.
Yeah. Has he made anything, though?
I don't think so. He's just drinking his thing.
Tastes like poison!
The entire class has gathered to watch Pop's final moments. Shock. Back to reality.
Back to reality.
No one cares anymore. School's over.
Done. We're out. That's normal, right?
He can die. It would appear that Pop's enthusiasm for trying new things despite obvious danger has inoculated him against poisons of all kinds.
Damn.
Holy shit.
I'm not sure the professors have here make enough money.
Hello! I turned into a ghost over here.
Seeing that you're shaken up by that really annoying student and all his nonsense, Colonel Sanders approaches you.
Wasn't listened to when alive. It's not going to be listened to when dead.
Yeah, exactly. I'm sorry you had to go through that. Please, let me walk you home. At night, the school building has taken another vibe entirely. It's dark and a little more than a little spooky. Ooh. I like the music, though.
Yeah, it's an evening, it's light, it's fairy. We're going to get kissed, maybe. I don't know.
I hope so. Ooh. Kiss me with your chicken mouth. Colonel Sanders stands in the quad's neon glow and speaks softly. Those mashed potatoes you made in class today.
Before you go on, I want you to know, they're not a great representation of my skills. I didn't even realize I was making them.
They were amazing.
Make me want to mash my lips against yours.
I want to mash your potatoes. Tasting them, it reminded me why I became so passionate about food to begin with.
Oh, he's gonna cry.
Colonel Sanders getting choked up. Cooking is obviously important to him in a way that you find inspiring. Now might be the perfect time to tell him you're developing feelings for him.
Oh.
Colonel Sanders.
Yes, Williams.
There's something I need to tell you. Heard it right there.
There's something I need to tell you first. Oh, jeez.
I feel you, Narita.
You see, when I was just a boy, I had a dream that one day I would be the one, be the greatest chef the world has ever seen. And every day since, I've been working toward that dream. Day and night, never stopping, never resting. Also lifting a lot of weights. Like, so many weights. You can tell. We should follow our dreams with all of our hearts, that our souls may grant them like wishes floating away on a star. Shooting star. Hey! No! You! Shut up! I'm the one here to say inspirational stuff and be the star of the story.
Are we forgetting that your cooking literally killed a guy?
You can't prove that. I also saw you kill that guy. What was his name? Somewhere in the distance, you hear a long, sad sigh.
Aww.
Forget him. We're talking about me. Me, 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 me. I'm the hero.
Oh! That is gross.
Wow, look at that. You could be the Spork Monster. Okay.
The Spork Monster is here to fight a hero!
Oh, I think I left the fridge door open. Later, nerds. That is horrific.
That is gross. What is it? It's like a dough ball.
It's a sport monster. It's like chicken batter. All just together. How dare you threaten me as I was letting down my guard and connecting with another chef on an emotional level.
Be afraid. Be very afraid of me because I'm a monster, see?
Is he rhyming on purpose or is that just a coincidence?
But before you can discuss Syntax any further...
Is that his name? Syntax?
It's a grammar thing.
Oh, I see.
It's a turn-based fight sequence! Dun, dun, oh, dun, 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 dun. What will you do? Oh.
It's like Final Fantasy!
We're going to attack.
Attack it.
Yeah.
Which attack will we use?
Cook with love.
I read that as cock with love then. I was like, fuck.
Get him. Cock with love. No.
Does one damage. Cook with love
does one damage. What?
It just got real. Sorry.
No, that's quite right. It just got real. That attack really upset Spork Monster. Spork Monster goes on the attack. They spit hot gravy at you.
Whoa.
You take one damage.
I have no idea how much health we've got.
Should we defend this time just to see what happens?
Yeah.
You decide to defend. Which defense will you use? Trepidation. You continue to stay back and endure whatever comes your way. Seems like a pretty weird strategy, but okay. You do you. Spork Monster focuses their mashed mind and draws energy from Mother Earth itself. Oh god, it's going for a spirit bomb. They grow larger and more intimidating. How will you respond? Attack.
Keep hitting it.
cook with love.
Keep cooking him.
Come on, cook with love. Sport monster is no quitter. Buffed up and ready to rumble, they go on the attack once again.
Whoa.
Sport monster uses utility tensile. You take 2 damage from the attack. Oh no. If you take much more damage, you're not going to be able to survive the battle.
Oh no.
Attack it.
Kill it.
Cook with love.
Ah! The music's making me want to go real fast. I'm like, dun, dun, dun.
Spork monster is oozing cheese sauce onto the lawn of the quad. I wonder who is going to have to clean that up.
Not me.
Feeling vulnerable, Spork monster prepares for its ultimate attack. Rounded edge. Vile villain, your reign of terror stops here.
Whoa.
Colonel Sanders summons the energy of 1,000 chickens.
Whoa!
Pot. Oh, you can see his chest. Pot pie. Power pinch.
I expected hair on his chest.
I know, right? Pot pie power pinch does 10 damage.
Damn.
Only 10. Spork monster is defeated.
That's all he needed.
You saved me.
And Ninja Spork monster spews steam into the night. Ooh. Finish him!
Finish him!
No student will ever walk the quad in fear again!
This monster messed with the wrong chef. Attack! Final attack.
You will never survive my student debt loan destruction!
Student debt loan destruction does 10 damage.
Oh, I wish I could just destroy my student loan. Damn.
That's right, just keep changing your address and don't pay it, it's fine. Spork monster is completely vaporized. Colonel Sanders looks in awe. You continue to surprise me, Willianne's. The defeated monster left behind a special item. Appears to be at first a cookbook, but upon closer expansion, it's so much more.
Is it his diary?
Book of magic spells with a golden chicken on the cover.
Oh, it's a grimoire.
This is where Colonel Sanders got all of his recipes from.
Killed monsters.
Yeah, you find a library card tucked inside. The last name ever to be signed out is Borko.
Could that be the dog?
Borko, that's a name sounds strangely familiar. That's a chicken sound, that is. Borko.
Oh.
Different kind of bork. Your blood is pumping as you stand in the quiet of the night holding the mysterious book in your hands. As you come down from your battle buzz, you realize that your final attack has left you completely depleted. The world around you begins to fade away.
Maybe he'll catch us in his arms.
Oh, without any energy to keep your eyes open, darkness overtakes you. Oh, he's
in our room!
He took us back to... How did he know where we live?
Well, maybe he likes us. He stalked us.
Look at the boy band poster as well. We got chicken poster too.
Oh my goodness. Oh yeah, we're into K-pop.
It's meant to be.
We've got some pearls on the desk.
They're anal beads, definitely.
Yes.
Some little ones. The image of
beginner's beads.
Beginner's beads. My first anal beads. Colonel Sanders flashes before your eyes as you fall asleep. He must have helped you get home. In your tired state, you don't know if you could have made it without him. What a guy.
What a guy.
You want to thank him, but you don't have enough strength to utter a single word. You feel your covers being pulled up over you as you are tucked in tightly.
Aww.
Chicken tuck.
Good night, my colonel.
Oh, so romantic.
Here we go again. In your dream, you're together with Colonel Sanders. For some reason, Sprinkles is also there, instructing your love. Dreams are weird.
Ooh. Look at him go!
The dead guy's there as well, at least. You wake on day 2 and attempt to process the wild visions you had. Were they memories or premonition?
Oh.
You lie in bed and stare at the ceiling, thinking about the secret you discovered while tasting Colonel Sanders' cooking yesterday. You can't believe he really used blank. And then there was a secret ingredient that Colonel Sanders went ahead and told you outright. Not much of a secret, huh? It's probably just because he already trusts you so much. That will be his downfall. That makes sense. Let's go with that.
Yeah, it seems safer.
you meet up with your bestie in front of the school.
Oh, she's still our bestie?
Yeah. Before you can tell her about the encounter with the spork monster, she launches into a story of her own.
Okay, I know this might sound a little strange, but I think I might be, I think I might like Clank.
Like him? Like?
I know it sounds it's moving too fast, but there's something about him. I like him. We got to talking after class, and he's actually a total sweet guy. Not only that, but he's really smart. He told me all kinds of stories about Colonel Sanders. Did you know that Colonel Sanders was the most popular kid in high school?
No, but that does make complete sense.
Yeah, but he was so popular that he was voted prom king at school he didn't even go to, and was also convertible. Wait, he also the convertible? That he self... rode into the front of the homecoming parade. That does not make sense. It was also the... He was a car?
Yeah. No, that ain't right.
I was like, he's a transformer too.
I'm thinking maybe something got lost in the pressure cooker language translation there. Yes.
Oh, phew.
Either way, maybe it'd be best if you took it slow with the new boy. I am, like I am, with Colonel Sanders.
You and Colonel Sanders, the coolest guy in school, the most famous student to ever attend University of Cooking, Academia for Learning, you're a thing now?
We definitely connected yesterday.
Sure you did, you're great. Why wouldn't he be into you, I guess?
Laughing at the implication that you and Colonel Sanders might be a thing is definitely not cool. You are great.
Aww.
You have an idea about how to prove that your love is real. Mm-hmm.
Well... if he's not into me, then why did he tell me one of his secret ingredients?
However, you don't tell her that you know a second ingredient too, which you have discovered on your own. Your bestie's eyes light up.
Drama, gossip, tea.
Holy shit.
A secret ingredient?
Yeah. I just said that. A secret ingredient. Is there a dramatic echo in here?
Miriam checks to make sure you're alone before continuing. ...
So this summer, while I was on vacation with my family, a lovely man approached me in the botanical garden while I was wandering.
This can't be good.
He told me all about his passion for spices. Secret spices. The man even gave me some to show me what he meant. He said he was a powder created from super duper rare dried flower petals, and that if I did him a big favor, I could have some of my own.
Please, Miriam, don't tell me.
So I filled my suitcase with them and brought them home. He was so nice, he even met me at the gate when I arrived. Later, when I cooked with them, a very strange feeling came over me, and the flavor was unlike anything I've ever tasted.
You got drugged.
Yeah.
I think you're being very liberal with the meaning of spices here.
Whatever. Anyway, we both share an interest in cooking, so we've stayed in touch, you know, like pen pals. I bet he would love to know more about this new spice.
Well, I'm definitely not supposed to share Colonel Sanders' secret recipe. And besides, I only know the one ingredient, so I doubt it'll be much use to anyone.
Please, 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 it would mean the world to me. No one has to know it came from you or Colonel Sanders.
What do you think? Should you protect Colonel Sanders' secret or share it with your bestie? Make up a fake one. Yeah, ooh. You can't tell
no.
The ingredient.
Everyone will be making the chicken.
Exactly, we can't have that. You quickly think of a fake ingredient name. I don't know, how about...
It was... Eye of Newt. I know, that sounds like some kind of witch's potion. But what can you do?
Eye of Newt? Wow!
Her eyes light up imagining such a thing, and you figure that you've satisfied her curiosity and she'll move on. However, she immediately turns around and does some thumb typing on her phone that you can't quite see. That's probably not good. Before you can ask her to confirm what she was definitely not texting secrets to other people, you're interrupted. A wind rushes in. Cherry blossom fills the air.
I wonder who it could be. Oh! He's on a horse!
I've got a horse outside. It's Colonel Sanders. He's arriving at school.
Ooh.
Stand back and admire his majestic glory.
Oh.
Colonel Sanders' horse is truly a thing of beauty.
I like it. Oh, he's got chamickens on his seat.
Yeah. Without ever acknowledging that he's being watched, he does a short horse dance before dismounting with a flourish. He then slaps the beautiful creature gently on its rear, sending it running free into the countryside. Fucking hell. Oh, you're so struck by the sight of him that you lose the ability to speak coherently. Oh, I didn't realize anyone was watching. Don't worry. He knows his way home. You attempt to compliment Colonel Sanders, but the words don't come out exactly right.
Oh,
fucking hell.
What a horseyful beaut you have. I mean, what a horseyful beaut you have. Oh, dang it. That's what I just said.
Being good friend, Miriam attempts to recover to cover for you.
Oh, Williams! Just got really nervous around people they like.
What? This is not helping. You fucked it for me.
Sorry. I mean, they got food poisoning and were up all night. It was gruesome. You should have seen it.
She gives you a wink and a smile, as if to say, situation handled. Can't blame a girl for trying. And with that, Colonel Sanders fucks off into the school, leaving you and Miriam to follow. Not impressed.
Oh.
When you enter the classroom, you can see your two rivals, Ashley and Van Van, who should really be arrested, but they're doing something bad. By the way, they're hiding. You know it must be really bad.
Oh, no.
Like counterfeiting recipes bad, experimenting with restricted ingredients bad, summoning a demon bad.
Oh, demon?
Down bad, you try to get a peek over Van Van's hulking shoulder. But he sees you coming. Whoa there, little one. I'm not sure you're ready to handle this.
Why don't you make like a bee and mind your own wax, honey?
Oh,
I want to use that one. I like that as an insult.
Make like a bee and mind your own wax, honey. It's just too much bee punishment.
I love it. I love it. Fucking love bees, man.
What shall we do?
Let's like the bottom one.
Yeah, go on. Let's do the bottom one then. You sit near the rivals, but leave your back turned to them. You even hear Van Van mutter something that sounds like a magic smell. However, he notices you eavesdropping and you try to cover your tracks and improvise an excuse.
Uh-oh.
Ahem! It's time for class and you're distracting the rest of us who want to learn!
Now you've upset them.
Oops, sorry.
Oh dear.
Oh, and you're the emperor of cooking, are you? You make the rules?
I'm not sure you know what a good meal if it ate you.
Oh. Being the best chef in the world takes more than just culinary skills. It takes creativity. It takes panache.
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 And it doesn't hurt to use a little evil.
Evil.
I didn't notice the little drumstick on her stockings as well.
Oh, I didn't even notice that either.
You can't see them now. You can't see them. You finally get a look at what they were hiding, and you instantly recognize it. It's a book! Just like the one you found after your encounter with the spork monster.
That's the same book I found last night in the quad! Look there, you can see him now. Oh, they're gone again!
Sorry! I got too distracted!
Ashley immediately elbows Van Van, who hides the book behind his desk.
Oh, I see him! I see him! I don't know what you're talking about. This book is a family heirloom, and it contains a secret.
You notice that they haven't just been studying the book. They've got Pop pinned to the wall, and they're tossing potato skins at him as he tries to catch them in his mouth.
No.
Have they not noticed that before?
We're playing! Heh heh heh!
Before you can dig any further, you're interrupted by the arrival of more students. It's almost time for class.
Dun dun dun!
Meep meep.
Clank must be running late. He's in such a hurry that it rolls right over Van Van's meaty foot. Hey, watch it, you bucket of bolts.
You watch how you talk to him. He didn't do anything. Bzzz, womp.
Who do you think you're talking to? I've never heard such language. Not even from a stand mixer.
Womp, womp.
He's pissed. No, your mother was a stand mixer.
Oh.
Werbs.
Oh, he's so angry.
Merkum.
Get him, Clank.
Van jumps to attack Clank, but Clank shocks Van, sending him flying across the room.
Yes, Clank!
Wrecked.
Protect me, Colonel Sanders. These crazed men are about to come to blows. I think it must be over me, but I'm not interested in either of them.
Ashley's tone has completely changed in an instant. She bats her eyelashes at Colonel Sanders. Surely he must know this is a ruse, right? Point that finger at her. Gentlemen, get a hold of yourselves. Save it for the arena at least. Or don't. Honestly, what do I care? I've got lofty career aspirations to focus on.
Maybe I can help you with your business plan.
Just then, Sprinkles arrives to signal the true start of the class day. He's panting, which doesn't seem that abnormal. He's a professor, but he's also a dog.
I like his little tie.
His little tie, yeah.
Students, please take your seats. I apologize for my late arrival. I spent the morning chasing a car all around town, and my tiny legs are very, very tired. But I'm here now, and I hope you're ready to learn.
Rub his furry dog belly. He loves it.
I'm doing it.
Rub it.
I'm rubbing it.
Rub it now. After he catches his breath, Sprinkles regains control of the classroom.
Without further ado, we review the global history of my favorite fowl, the chicken.
You want to pay attention to the lesson. You truly do.
Which is why in 1776, at the signing of the Declaration of Independence, it was the chicken who first signed their name.
But you can't help but daydream about Colonel Sanders, and you miss most of the important parts. Oh,
whoopsie.
No. When you come to, Sprinkles is holding a tray of food in front of you. Oh, uh-oh. Shit.
Well, Williams!
Naturally, this appears to you to be a sample platter. Which item do you want to sample? Ooh.
A pepper?
A brightly coloured pepper stands out from the other items. It sparkles in a most eye-catching way. So naturally, you reach out to it, grab it, and eat it right away. However, your body is not prepared for the heat!
No!
Oh god, here we go. The pepper's triggered intense spice hallucination. It feels like forever as you trip through the universe. My friend. This guy again. I'm here to give you an important message. You must avenge my death to fulfill your destiny. All you must do is... Cough, cough. I was saying to fulfill your destiny, all you must do is... Cough, cough. Sorry, I think I've still got some spice stuck in my throat. It's fine, I'll work through. Cough. To fulfill... Cough. The prophecy. Cough, cough. You must. You feel yourself to begin to regain consciousness. Oh. Oh, man.
He never gets any words in ever.
The prophecy. You come to and find everyone else is staring at you.
Oh, angry boy. That pepper was the last of its kind on Earth, and now it's gone forever.
Shit.
Whoops.
You think to yourself, geez, I should pay better attention.
It was the only option. We know what water tastes like. I don't want a dog biscuit.
I'm sure something evil would have happened either way.
Yeah. We all make mistakes. I'm sure he'll forgive you. Someday. Come on, it's time for lunch.
Before anyone can relax, the cafeteria lights dim.
Oh.
And your rival's making a dramatic announcement. Today's lunch will be prepared.
Via timed competitive cook-off.
The levels of theatrics with these two is off the charts. Step up and tell them you're on. Go on.
Oh, you're get on.
A bit of lunchtime competition. Count me in. If I have to wipe the tables with you fools before I set my lunch down on it, then so be it. good?
Yep. Sorry. I was trying to sip quietly, and I was just like, oh no!
I'm not the fool, you're the fool. Good one, Van Van. You are like your gumption, Willy Ann's. I'll be watching your performance.
Mm. Oh, he will be watching us.
Just as things reach a boiling point, Sprinkle steps in. Surely he'll put a stop to this madness.
No, no, students. Please settle down. This is a lunchroom, not a sporting court.
Finally, a little sense. You breathe a sigh of relief.
At least not until we turn on the timer.
Just then, a huge light blasts you in the face, flashing the words, timer ready.
Oh, gosh. That's what I'm talking about. Ow-woo!
Just imagine, I don't know if you've ever seen Futurama much.
I've seen bits, yes, yes, yes.
The president, he just goes, ow-woo! In the head jar.
Yes, yes, I have. Yeah.
I stand corrected. The hard way builds solidly a foundation of confidence that cannot be swept away. Mm-hmm. And that's an original quote by me. In case anyone was wondering, I hope it's a message lifts you. Hope its message lifts you to victory.
It's a bit of a shit quote, sorry, Colonel. Like a diamond, I was formed under pressure, and now it's my time to shine. I will defeat you myself.
You wish, bitch.
Yeah,
the music is on, yeah. You had this chicken, and you made mashed potatoes and gravy in day one, and you're feeling like you can really impress him again here.
We got this.
It's time to boil some water for the potatoes. Think fast. If the timer runs down, you'll be forced to pick randomly.
You ready?
I'm ready. What temperature does water boil at? Oh, the middle one. That's right. But how would you even gotten into the school without knowing that?
I wouldn't have known. Winner gets to rub my furry belly. Let's that enticing offer motivate you.
Oh, it does. You're going to need to season this chicken before you cook it. You don't know Colonel Sanders' recipe exactly, but you have an idea.
Oh, how many herbs?
11! I know!
We know that one!
That's right, you might not know all the ingredients yet, but you're at least headed in the right direction.
Tail wagging.
Now that you've got some basic steps going, it's time to elevate your craft.
What state of mind
offers the most flavor?
Trust?
Vigilance.
Oh! No! I don't know what
it was right. You must take this opportunity for granted and hope that you succeed.
I don't know what we clicked.
I think it was trust.
Okay.
So it must have been right. You and your classmates are rooting for you, but Ashley is simply stronger and faster than you. You better pick up the pace if you want to survive. When you're a child, your father told you something. It's about you to never forget where you came from. Every day, you meditate on his advice and draw energy from that place. Now would be a great time to harness that energy. So where does it come from?
That one?
Small town, yeah. That's right. This is your shot and you're not going to miss it.
We had one second left. Aroo!
You try to shut out the noise of the arena to focus on your cooking.
What is the sound of success? Sizzling! Bubbling! Silence! Sizzling! No!
What? Is it bubbling?
Don't know.
Oh, it's silence.
Don't make me get the spray bottle.
Next question. Colonel Sanders at the corner of your eye. I believe in you, Willy Ann's.
We got this.
He's actually cheering you on. Which would be awesome, except for knowing he's watching you make you totally forget what you were doing.
Fuck!
Shit. All you do is think about Colonel Sanders.
On a horse! No!
Oh, big meaty horse.
Oh, God.
Oh, shit. Kids pick one.
No, I did. Oh, sorry. I was too distracted.
I think they all would have been wrong, to be fair.
Yeah.
That was...
Sprinkles.
He was stranded on this desert island with the only dessert cookbook. Which do you take? What a hunk. Oh,
I can't.
God, what's
We're
happening?
Too distracted.
I can't focus.
I know, right?
You know what? Shouldn't you be focused on the challenge? You're falling behind. Oh, God. No! Woof, woof!
We're getting too distracted.
We are so distracted.
Colonel Sanders, you're struggling to keep up. And at the next station over, Ashley has begun plating up elements of her dish. It's colourful and complex.
Oh, no.
You toss biscuit dough into a stand mixer, and as you do, the crowd gasps.
Yikes!
Z-bleh.
I know you love nothing more than seeing a fellow put a fellow appliance, there we go, utilized in a kitchen battle, but sometimes that means sacrificing the personal touch. You might not have any hands, but Williams does, and a good chef needs to be touching the dough to know it's properly mixed.
There's an easy way and a hard way. You don't get far by going the easy way. Oh, no. When you hear everyone talk and you realize how serious your error was, you immediately shove your hand into the mixer and rescue the dough before it's overmixed.
Williams, no!
You're not fast enough and your hands get stuck. It's immediately crushed by the quickly spinning beaters. There's no way you'll be able to use that hand for the rest of the match.
Oh, no.
Oh, Colonel Sanders shakes his head in shame. It's all going wrong.
I got one question wrong.
You got one wrong and then it mashed her hand.
Jeez.
What you often find is the easy way can turn out much, much more difficult.
Fuck. Everyone, stop what you're doing right now. This battle is over.
It can't be. I was close to finishing my dish.
Sweetheart, look at your hand. You simply can't go on. Oh, that's too bad. And here I am with a completed dish ready to serve. Surely that makes me the winner by default.
No.
No, no. It wouldn't be fair to compare the two on account of William's injury.
You see Sprinkles begin to lick his doggy chops as he locks onto the dish.
But I suppose you should at least tell us what you prepared. Well, because I'm the sweetest, I skip straight to dessert.
Ugh.
Under this white chocolate dome, you'll find a wide array of delights taking you on a journey of flavor that tastes good and tells a story of excellence. I was going to ask Williams to do the honor, but since you're injured, I'm afraid that pouring that creamer of delicate hot chocolate sauce might just be too difficult for you. Colonel Sanders, if you wouldn't mind lending me your strong, steady hands.
No, Colonel Sanders pours the hot chocolate sauce on top of the dome, causing it to melt away, revealing the ingredients hidden within.
No! Inside,
oh, wow.
That is impressive. Inside, you'll find a delicate fried cheese croquette atop a slice of honeycomb, ice cream two ways, tender nougat, and pearls of blueberry gilet?
Gilet, yeah, let's go with gilet.
I'm assuming it's the blue balls.
Yeah, she's got blue balls.
Blue balls, he blue balled the colonel.
Colonel Sanders seems intrigued, but not as impressed, as he dips his finger in the chocolate sauce. Simplicity isn't your strong suit, is it, Ashley?
Oh, you.
So he places the sauce-covered fingers in his lips. Ashley leans over and whispers something into his ear. A dab of sauce sticks to his mustache.
Internalize it. He doesn't need to see us angry.
No.
Oh, God.
Oh, they burst into flames. Oh, dear.
We burst into flames.
The flames cause your eyebrows to catch fire as you turn to ash as they fall off onto your face, which means people will have a hard time understanding your emotions for the rest of the semester, perhaps forever. Oh,
Jesus.
Shit. It's really gone wrong.
Oh, it's really going bad.
By your poor performance, not to mention your crispy fried brow. You run for the quad to be alone. The beautiful weather feels like an insult. Inside of you, a storm rages. It's Colonel Sanders. He's probably here to tell you that he and Ashley are in love and you have decided to get married. Oh,
that jumped quickly.
No, he won't even ask you to cater his wedding because you're a terrible chef and an awful person.
Wow, no this you're not.
You try to hide from him, but he approaches you directly. I know you're hurting right now. Not just from the devastating loss, but from that run-in with the mixer and a small fire. We should get that checked out.
I'm fine. Can't you just leave me alone? I'm a loser. Not fit for you. Fill your fryer. I'll never be a master chef.
Failure is part of life, not just for you, but for all of us. Do you think I've never failed at anything before?
That's exactly what I think.
Well, then think again. I wasn't always the man you see before you. Enrolled in culinary school, incredibly handsome, successfully motivated. Well, handsome, sure. I was born that way. Oh, of course he was.
Maybe sure he's was. Worth it. Maybe he was born that way.
But I've walked other paths and arrived at dead ends. I was passionate about life, but I failed an obstetrician?
Oh, no, but he's crying. He's meaning the words he's saying.
I was passionate about justice, but I failed as a lawyer.
Wow.
I was passionate about livestock, but I even failed as a mule handler. That one especially humiliating. Mules can be so cruel.
Oh, life. We get law now. Colonel Sanders' cruel. Law.
Yeah, cruel mules. Aww. I lost my business partner to a gunfight.
Damn.
Holy shit.
It's getting serious down here.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
People see my delicate ribbon tie and my well-kept beard and assume that I've got it all together. Which is true now, but it hasn't always been. Yeah. Oh, he's perfect now, though.
Yeah, he's, now he is.
Yeah. Sounds like this guy could really use a hug.
No, he seems fine. He's making us feel better.
I've resolved that I was going to amount to something. No amount of hours, labor, or money could deter me from giving me the best life I had to give.
Wow.
As Colonel Sanders changes focus, you can see something ignite inside of him. A burning passion.
Oh.
One has to remember that every failure can be a stepping stone to something better. My new dream is pure, it's honest, and something that a humble man in a crisp white suit can be proud of.
Wow.
One will create a new chain. I will create a new chain of chicken restaurants that will bring joy to the entire world and make up for my past misdeeds.
Oh.
Ah, the music.
Yay!
And Pop ruins it.
Bastard. Just as your moment grows intimate, you are interrupted by a threatening, shadowy presence.
Oh, fuck off.
Battle Scarred Night Before prepares you for the worst. It's a spork monster.
Gorko, the spork monster is here to fight a hero!
Anyone's feeling a bit of deja vu?
I'm sorry, Gorko, but I could have sworn we already battled you last night.
That was Borko, my twin, and I, Gorko, am here to avenge them!
Are you stronger than Borko?
Well, we're twins, so... No, not really. We're pretty much exactly equal in every way, why'd you ask?
Colonel Sanders smirks. New radio's the same page as you.
It's just that we beat Borko pretty easily, so I don't think you'd have much of a chance. Not to mention I feel really guilty about that. If I could take it back, I would.
No, I wouldn't.
His fucking face on the...
Oh, he's just like, oh.
I think that Williams is saying is, can't we just be friends? Life is too short for making enemies.
I suppose we don't need to fight. It's just that I've got these pointy teeth and claws.
All the better for enjoying tasty foods. Sure, you like to eat, don't we all?
Of course I do.
Inspiration strikes you and you come up with a quick idea.
Chomp on this!
You toss a biscuit into Gorko's open mouth and he devours it in one gulp.
Nom 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 nom. Delicious! You're much nicer than the evil students who once upon a time turned me into this creature who stands here today.
Bastards.
No, no.
I don't believe it. You were human once.
Wait, that means we killed a real person.
Oh shit, yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh. Oh no, it's even worse! Well, no, I was a chihuahua.
No!
I was still a student at the school until one day some mean kids with a magic spell book cast a dark enchantment on me and I was forever transformed.
A magic spell book?
Precisely. Borko used to have a copy, but somewhere along the way I've lost it. If you find such a bug, I beg of you, respect it. You're a powerful chef, and you shouldn't rely on such dark and evil magic. No, you shouldn't be protecting the innocent from those who would cheat them through sorcery and guile. If you need me, don't fear. I'll be here, there, somewhere.
It sounds like there are some bad cooks in the kitchen of life. Willianne's, together, I am sure we can defeat them.
Got to defeat those evil two bitches.
Come back to my hideaway and we can discuss.
I could bet you your room.
Oh, a personal invite. You can't imagine what Colonel Sanders' home must be like. It sounds like you're about to find out.
Mm. Yeah, baby. Oh, hell damn. Yeah. I want to live here.
Yeah, stepping inside Colonel Sanders' home, surrounded by his things, you start to feel a special bond with him. Chicken.
Look at the baby version of him. And oh, yeah. Wait, there's a future version of him, too.
Oh, he's on a camel as well.
Oh.
It looks like you have lived such an exciting life, Colonel Sanders.
Every day can be an adventure if you approach it with the right attitude. Oh, fuck off. Long ago, I made the decision to never stop searching, never stop working, and never stop imagining. Have you been working on any new recipes of your own lately? I'm always excited to talk about food with another ambitious chef.
Well, there is something. It's just a side dish that I've been tinkering with, trying to find the right balance of flavors and textures. I'm not sure if I've nailed it yet, but I'm close.
Colonel Sanders' eyes perk up as he starts to wonder what dish you might be describing.
It's meant to pair with something spicy, or something crispy, perhaps both.
Ooh.
Now you've got him right where you want him. Should you reveal your new creation to him or keep it a secret? Reveal it!
Reveal it!
Show him your butthole! You decide that you'll ever be, and you share your original cooking with Colonel Sanders. Before you can talk yourself out of it, you decide to dive in headfirst. You reach into your lunch bag for a special dish that you've been keeping on ice all day!
All day!
I present to you my original coleslaw!
Ooh.
The shredded cabbage dish glistens in the light of Colonel Sanders' luck. Say hideaway.
Oh, he's gonna steal it from us, I bet you.
Magnificent! He is, yeah. Mm-hmm. Together you chow down on his creamy slaw.
On his creamy slaw.
Spoonful remains in the bowl. Do you mind if I hold on to the last bite? I'd like to have it around so I can admire the taste later and think back on this moment.
So you can make it.
He's gonna steal it. You could offer him to make him more. It. But he seems like a very sentimental kind of guy. He's definitely stealing
this. He's
stealing. Sure, why not? Please make yourself comfortable. I'll be back in just a moment. You realize that this would be the perfect time to do some snooping.
Snoop, ooh. Snoop.
Now in the room are various items that you can look closer at. Each item seems to radiate memories and emotions. Tap on an item to discover more about the Colonel.
Oh, I'm going straight to that candle, if that's okay.
Go for it. Scented candle. Try to identify the smell. Power tool? Freshly starched collar? Piece of wood floating in the lake. Summer of 69. No, it's just one of the secret ingredients. It's blank.
What'd you like?
I want the baby picture.
Baby!
Baby crawls across the floor from goatee and the mustache combo sports. You figure this must be Colonel Sanders himself. Maybe that is a drumstick. He'd be waving on like a rattle.
Oof. Oh, you cut
Sorry,
me off.
Sorry, I did. Fuck.
Probably the same person who would make their own face or logo of the company founded. Am I right?
Wow.
Tap on a screen. Discover more.
Go for the chimicken.
You notice a very realistic stuffed chicken sitting on the corner table. When you pick it up, you realize it's just realistic. It's real.
Whoa.
Taxidermy must have been important to Colonel Sanders when he was alive.
A little notice clip to the chicken's foot. It reads, "The true state bird of the great state of Kentucky." Tapping on time. Let's go. On the side room, the side snoop in the room.
The door, quick!
Oh, Colonel Sanders' closet to find a row of his signature white suits hanging within. You take one off his hanger and try it on.
I bet you're good as fuck. Oh.
The check is a big, big for you, but it's soft and comfortable. You give yourself a deep hug and breathing in his scent. They say that home is where the heart is. Is this what they meant?
His suit?
In a suit. Before you can look any further, you hear Colonel Sanders returning. He has a new dish that he's been working on and he wants you to taste it. Aww. You try and act casual until he asks you why you're wearing his jacket.
Awkward. Whoops.
I don't usually loan those out, but I must say it looks good on you.
What if I was only wearing the jacket?
Oh, crap. The jacket. You forgot to take it off.
Tell him the truth, tell him you're cold, decide what is your moment, make a move on him.
Is now the right time to make a move?
Probably not. Well, he's just made us food, and he's obviously very food-obsessed.
Tell him the truth.
Yeah.
You confess.
I think I've developed feelings for you.
I might be developing feelings for you, too, but I'm concerned. Can't let anything get in the way of my dreams. Oh, no.
No.
Overwhelmed, you take off the jacket and run to the door.
No!
But the thought of leaving the girl in the midst of such an emotional breakthrough gives you pause. Stop yourself.
Good.
Colonel!
Yes, Willie Adams.
I honestly think this might be the beginning of something wonderful.
I think you're right. We should take things slow. You talk late into the night and drift off into a slumber.
Oh, and then chickeny hands.
And he fingers your butt.
Dream sequence! That's why we're having such a good dream. Oh, yeah, look at the good dreams.
You awake to a beautiful morning in Colonel Sanders' hideaway. It stayed the night, holy shit! Did you make the right decision on how to respond to Colonel Sanders? Only time will truly tell. Today is the day that could change the rest of your life. It's the last day of the semester. You think about this new secret ingredient you just learned about. Blank.
So we've learned about three ingredients now.
Yeah. Some jurisdictions. Oh, God, it's blank legal. Legal. Children.
Wow.
The recipe is a secret. How will they know?
It's children tears. That's what a secret ingredient.
Yeah. Your thoughts are interrupted when Colonel Sanders emerges from to the room.
Emerges.
He's holding a gorgeously plated breakfast and your mouth waters sight of it. I am really hungry now, fuck.
I say, I'm like vibrating ready for food.
Oh, here's a simple breakfast I just whipped up.
Oh.
Chicken for breakfast?
Yes.
It's meticulous. You taste Colonel Sanders' food and it takes you on a journey. When you return, he is waiting to ask an important question. So, would you like to say we're the perfect match?
Yes.
How presumptuous. My cuisine and your taste buds, that is. Wow. Such confidence, such grace. Could he be the world's greatest gift to cookery?
I think, should we flatter him?
Let's flatter him, of course.
Yeah.
You know, I think we make a great team.
If he cooks me chicken every day, I'm happy. Man,
yeah, exactly.
Fuck my dreams.
Fuck all my dreams.
Fuck all my dreams. I'll sit and eat chicken.
Yeah. A single tear begins to pool the corner of his eye as he gazes out the window. And with the right business partner, I know I can't fail.
You want my coleslaw, bitch, don't you?
He wants that business partner. I can be talking to you. It's all happening so quickly. Overcome with emotion and confused by your feelings, you're on the verge of tears, unable to speak, but only the answer that you could find is to run out the door and go home. It's still one more day of school, after all. University of Cooking School Academy for Learning waits for no one.
Bam!
You get home to find something very surprising. Your best friend is there, waiting for you.
Aww. Where have you been? Because I've had one heck of a night. I've been desperate to talk to you about it, but I couldn't find you. I got word that something bad happened to you.
It's okay. I was just...
But now that it turns out you're fine, I can finally get you up to speed on the saga of Miriam.
Sure, but...
You will not believe what happened to me after school yesterday. I went on a date.
I think I can believe that.
Since I've been partnered up with Clank, he asked me to go out with him. Of course I told him you don't. Better keep your dials turned to polite and respectful. I'm not that kind of girl. But he was just interested in spending some one-on-one time together and getting to know me. So I said, yeah, sure. I can get to know a little metallic guy like you. Long story short, he took me skydiving with his friends, but things quickly spiraled out of control.
Did she just say skydiving? As if that's a typical first date to go on with a talking pressure cooker.
And now I'm not really sure where we stand.
You don't give Miriam time to tell the whole story, however. Bottling up the details of your own night is just too much to bear.
And I went on a date too, back to Colonel Sanders' house where I spent the night with him. L-l-l-l-l-l.
You what?
Nothing happened, but the emotional connection. Wowzers.
Aww.
Together with your bestie, you feel that you can do anything. When you arrive at school, you encounter the rivals in the quad. You can tell from a distance they're picking on Pop, though he himself might not quite grasp that fact.
He's fine then.
Because you know, he's Pop. Everyone loves Pop.
Yeah.
What's a swirly? It sounds delicious.
Oh, it's great. I'll order you one up right away.
I'll have my swirly with sprinkles, please. Heh. Sprinkles is a dog and a treat.
You can get your swirly dipped, too. Oh, that sounds naughty.
Why don't you pick on someone your own size?
Because I'm literally the biggest person at this school.
There is that horse that Colonel Sanders rides to school, but he would dare pick on such a gentle and beautiful creature.
You've got some nerve, Willianne, suggesting I pick on a defenseless horse.
Now you're twisting my words, and I won't have it.
You clench your fist, but the injury from yesterday's mix accident makes you wince with pain.
Ooh.
Doesn't look like you can go on cooking like that. You might as well just give up.
I'll never give up. Ever.
Colonel Sanders arrives just as things appear to be close to boiling over. A natural, intuitive person, he senses something has been going on. Is everyone excited for the final day of school? Williams, how's that hand feeling? I'm sure you'll be back in fighting form by this afternoon.
Fingers crossed. Aren't you concerned about my hands, Colonel? Yesterday I almost broke a nail. Winning is so hard.
Technically, I don't believe a winner was decided, but your presentation was quite impressive. What's he doing complimenting her?
But what about the flavor of my delicate, warm, gooey chocolate sauce?
My butthole! It was clear that you're passionate about how your food is received.
That's a lot of words to say. It was bland.
Excuse me, William. I am more than capable of speaking for myself. No.
Maybe you could tell me more of your thoughts as we walk into class, Colonel.
I'm always interested in discussing the fine arts of fine food. See you inside, Willianne. No! Annoyed by Colonel Sanders' inability to see Ashley for who you know she is. You walk across the quad and get some distance. In an attempt to distract yourself from how slighted you feel by that interaction with Ashley, you take out the spellbook you recovered yesterday and start flipping through the pages.
Evil! Whoa, what's that book? It looks like bad news.
It's just something I found lying around. It would appear it has some sort of grimoire. I don't really believe in that magic stuff.
A grimoire? Like a book of spells? I don't know. Who would spend so much time decorating a magic book if it wasn't really powerful?
I can think of one surefire way to find out.
You open a page covered with arcane warnings. Cast only in case of extreme emergency, it says around the edges of the page.
I could use this spell here, and it says it would erase anyone I choose from all my memories. If I scrub out Colonel Sanders, it would probably help me focus better on the upcoming final exam.
Oh no, don't do that. That is way too drastic. Could you do something else, like anything else, not rooted in dark magic? Maybe tie a string around your finger.
Okay, fine. It is drastic, but desperate times call for desperate measures. You got a memory erasing spell sitting right in front of you and a pretty good excuse to try it out.
No, I'm Team Miriam. Don't do it.
This is a mistake. You take your friend's advice and put the book away. It's almost time for class.
We don't need no evil school.
No. That would definitely backfire.
Yeah.
Sprinkles is already in the room waiting for students to arrive. He clears his voice and makes a quick announcement.
I want you all to know I feel something of a dark moment coming on, but I assure you, it's nothing to be afraid of.
His cute little nose scrunches up, and he begins to breathe quickly. Give him a snack.
Give him a snack.
You reach into your backpack and grab some homework from the last semester that you forgot to turn in. Sprinkles immediately goes for it and gobbles up the sheet of paper with a piece of fresh chicken rawhide.
I apologize for the outburst. I know it seems cliche, but not much in this world satisfies like an ungraded work. My, Williams, were you studying something with cinnamon?
I've been sitting on that on a lecture series on the art of cake baking. How insightful.
This actually brings up an important point. Thank you, Williams, for reminding me to dole out this indispensable bit of wisdom. You see...
But before we can go any further, Miriam's love drama spills over into the class.
I told you to save it for after class! You think I wanted to be thrown from a plane strapped to a stranger?
Miriam and Clank appear to be arguing, but you haven't learned to speak Clank's language of mechanical noises. Whirr!
But no, you had to show off your cool kid friend, Jeff and Joanne, J&J forever. Watch us from a triangle, form a triangle in the midair as we descend. Triangles are the strongest shape, don't you know?
Bzz, bzz.
Yeah, well, that doesn't make it a great date.
Babe, whirr!
Then take Jeff and Joanne with you. You can all hold hands as you pedal down the mountain or off a cliff for all I care.
Sad beep. Clank begins to shudder. Steam pours out the gaps in his paddles and then a loud ding stops him in his tracks. He's fucking exploded.
He's broken. Bzz. No amount of seasoning is going to make me want to eat that, Clank.
Burps out a completely deep-fried sneaker. Considering that he himself has wheels, not feet, it's not entirely clear where this came from.
Oh, God.
In terms of deep-fried deep-friend footwear, I guess it looks okay.
Clank slowly rolls out the room, not to be alone with his shoe. Everyone tries to pretend that they didn't see that entire thing go down. Nothing like a loud public brator to cast a pall over the final day of school.
Oh. Good text. Well, that was unfortunate, but we mustn't be distracted from what lies ahead. The final competition showdown, challenge, exam, TM. I'm still working on the title, but I think you get it. Test time approaches. See you all in the arena.
But before you can think about the upcoming competition, there's a very beautiful soul nearby in need of a pep talk.
Hey, Miriam, are you okay? Aww.
Okay, I'm so mad I could crash a tiny mug spilling several droplets of hot cocoa all over the floor. How could he embarrass me in class like that in front of everyone?
Oh, a tiny cocoa is a delicious treasure, so you know that this breakup is no joke, even if the source of her frustration is a silly boy.
I know that you know this, but I'm gonna come out and say it out loud. You don't need anyone! Me and you, we're going to cruise through this final test and hit the carpool lane to Success City.
No.
Miriam brightens up, imagining a wind rushing through her short bangs, but she hesitates to embrace the feeling all the way.
You're not going to saddle up, wild Kuno Sanders Stallion, and ride off into the sunset without me?
Of course not. Well, maybe sorta, but I'm sure there's a pony out there with your name on it, and a ranch big enough for the both of us. And whoever else we want to bring along. It's not Pop or Clank or anyone else you meet today, tomorrow, or this whole year. So what? You're a special person who shouldn't settle for the first someone to show you a little interest. Anyhow.
Aww, what a real friend you are.
It's great advice. I know. I'm so cool.
You're so good.
Miriam gives you a big hug and wipes away the tears from her cheeks.
I should really review my menu for today. I'm going to make a very special soup.
Soup? Fuck that.
don't know. Oh, I had soup for dinner the other night. It was pretty good.
That's so right. You were ill, so it's okay.
Yeah.
Soup is piss. and I bet Professor Dog is going to love it up. While you were pep-talking Miriam, the completely missed lunch. That's okay, because you had a better idea of how to spend the time before your exam.
Uh-oh.
You decided to head to the arena for a bit to practice a dish.
Ooh, what are we practicing?
The location of your final challenge. A test of will. A test of courage. A test of talent. And a chance to beat the pants off Van Van, the supposed man-man, and his eviler counterpart, Ashley. As planned, you begin to run through a quick test of recipe you've been working on. Willianne's famous chicken pot pie.
Ooh.
After practicing for months, making this dish comes second nature to you, and you're able to quickly get a fresh pot pie in the oven. As soon as you do, you cram your cram session is interrupted by Colonel Sanders.
Oh,
Williams, what are you doing here? There's still time before the final exam. Oh,
just taking it all in. I'm big into visualizing success, and I'm looking at my station and picturing victory.
Yeah, I believe in you, William.
The pot pie has begun to bake, and the smell is slowly filling the space around you. Visualizing, huh? That's too bad. I was here hoping you were cooking something delicious. You'd usually happily share your food with anyone who's hungry, but the last time you let Colonel Sanders get in your head, it cost you a cook-off. You decided it's time to bet. You decide that it's time to put your cooking above your romantic desires, but that decision gets hard to stick to when
Ding.
The oven timer goes off behind you. Oh.
I think we should fess up.
We gotta fetch up. He loves cooking.
He loves our food too.
And that was his special move.
Yeah. Okay, you got me. I'm doing a little more than visualizing.
I know. My nose can smell pot pie from 400 yards.
Wow, that's a long time.
And an oddly specific distance, but you'd expect nothing less from such an oddly specific man.
You knew it was a pot pie just from the smell?
Not just a pot pie, but a chicken pot pie with an all-butter crust. And my nose is telling me something else.
Oh, no! Is it burning?
No, I can smell that, but it was made with a heaping helping of TLC. But it'll probably start burning any second if you don't pull it out! Pull out!
Pull out!
The moment of truth.
Wow!
Look at that.
That
the best
great.
Pot pie I've ever tasted. I've always loved country cooking, and I could eat this all day. There's no time left. The final showdown is about to begin.
Bum, bum, bum!
Sprinkles lays down the ground rules.
There are no rules, that is, except to cook with everything you've got!
Oh, we can stab each other then.
Oh, nice!
You step up for the cook-off of a lifetime. You decide that mac and cheese plus the pot pie you've been practicing are just the dishes that'll push you over the edge to victory. Meanwhile, both Van Van and Ashley are prepping wildly elaborate dishes for their usual over-the-top bullshit. Miriam has a giant magnifying glass and several sets of tweezers.
Oh.
She's definitely preparing to go big going small.
Oh.
Colonel Sanders seems to be harnessing his 11 herbs and spices, but he's trying to find a way to improve something on perfect. His original recipe are fried chicken.
Read the bags. What does the baggie say for the herbs?
The intensity of the room starts at a full 10 out of 10 with a frenzy of action. Everyone is calling out cool, special cooking moves as they prepare their food. Wow, this is getting serious.
So serious.
Yeah, any good anime.
This is like Food Wars all over again.
Oh, Food Wars. Oh. Colonel Sanders batters his chicken and levitates through the air.
Batter my chicken.
Egoisha! Miriam furiously injects energy ingredients into an itty-bitty pot of broth.
Best friend, Buster Blaster!
Van Van flexes his pectorals as he chops open a sea urchin. Let's rock and roll. Ashley scoops her pastries off the tray with lightning speed.
Shallow personality spectacle.
Even Clank gets in on it.
Oh.
Five dial pressure point chicken cooking technique.
Yeah.
Wait, where did Clank learn to speak English?
It was a singularity, as was foretold.
We mustn't let it happen, or the appliance uprising will take us all. Self-destruct. Fanban quickly unplugs Clank and rolls him out of the back door of the arena.
Ah, Fanban did something useful.
Yeah. What the fuck? You frantically prepared dishes. You notice Ashley has her spellbook out and she is going to use some dark magic to turn the tide. You've got a book of your own and you're desperate not to see her win another battle. Should you take this opportunity to fight magic with magic, even if it's most certainly evil magic?
No, do it the hard way.
Do it the hard way. Who needs magic when you've got passion?
Yeah, we got so much passion.
I'm going to do it the hard way.
Colonel Sanders sees that you've chosen to win on your own terms and he gives you a subtle wink from across the room.
Oh, yeah, baby.
I believe in you, Williams. Miriam notices too.
And I've always believed in you, Williams, since we were little kids because I'm your best friend forever. Believe it.
I just told you to believe it, so believe it.
Believe it.
Believe it. You turn to notice Miriam is at your station cheering for you. Miriam, what about your dish? If you're cheering, who's cooking?
Tiny food, short cook time. I'm actually already done, so I thought I'd help you.
Oh, that's sweet, but...
Miriam tosses a handful of spices directly into your boiling noodles.
It's the secret ingredient.
Oh my god. However, she doesn't know that you lied. The ingredient was made up. And where in the world would she get an eye of newt from?
Oh no.
The boiling pot explodes, sending Miriam flying backwards, and the watery noodles begin to swirl in the air, bubbling in the dark cloud that thickens and congeals before your very eyes. Ah, we shouldn't have lied to you.
No! It is I, Steve, the spork monster.
Steve, wait, what happened to Gorko? You're not here to battle me, are you?
We spork monsters are many. I think Gorko had the day off. But you have conjured Steve, and I hate to battle. So I'd say you're doing pretty all right. Oh, hey, you're in the middle of a cooking competition. I love this stuff. It's better than TV. You crazy kids and your culinary skills really impress me. Mind if I hang out?
I'm sorry, Steve, but I'm kind of in the middle of something. Do you mind?
Steve the Spork Monster notices that you've got the grimoire stashed beneath your cooking station.
I see what you're up to. Crisscrossed some magical items and accidentally summoned me, huh?
Huh. Well, you guessed it, sorta. If you're here, would you mind tossing me fresh noodles in a pot of salted water?
I'd love to. I've always wanted to be a top chef, actually. You know, when I was just a little spork pup back in the old country.
I love this voice that you've gone for. You can feel the spork monster winding up to tell a very long and involved story. You don't know exactly it came from, but it seems like it's probably lonely there.
Aww.
Actually, you know what? Maybe you could watch from the stands. I really need to focus on this competition.
I understand. It's kind of like that time in monster school that I had fallen asleep during scare tactics class and when I woke up...
You toss a serious stare at Steve and he takes the hint.
Never mind. I'll tell you later. Good luck.
Get out of here, Steve, you fucking idiot.
Oh.
Having suffered, serious music, this huge setback, you don't know how you could ever win.
The top one. We're not giving up. After all this, we've been through.
After all this.
I can do this. I have what it takes. I came here to win.
Oh.
Your hair turns mac and cheese orange as culinary energy flows through your body.
We're becoming one.
We're super sand lesbian.
My heart is pure, my hands are steady, and my taste buds have been preparing their entire lives for...
Yes, Williams, you are the chosen one. You will avenge me.
The power you'd been summoning immediately fades back out.
You interrupted my inspiring monologue.
Sorry.
My heart is pure, and my hands are steady. My taste buds have been preparing their entire lives for this moment. I will show the world my cookery.
Yeah.
You begin to levitate off the ground. Energy courses through your body.
Wow.
You know that with this power you can do anything.
Anything.
And a mashed up hand. Except turn back time, which would have been super useful because while you were powering up, your chicken pot pie overcooked in the oven, it can't be served.
What the fuck?
Don't worry, Willianne. You may have suffered some setbacks, but all is not lost. Impressed with your fortitude, Colonel Sanders decided that you have earned his support. I've been watching you today, and I must say I'm truly impressed. You've been thinking on your feet and rolling with the punches. He steps up to your station and stands right beside you.
Yes!
I'm here to help! All you've managed to make is mac and cheese, and his time is almost up, so you're going to need it. But Colonel Sanders, what about the test? What will happen to you? What about the rules? Following the rules has never been really my thing. If I follow my heart.
Dun dun dun.
What a guy. And there are no rules anyways.
No. So. They can do what they want.
Exactly. Colonel Sanders unfolds a delicate white towel to reveal the most delicious fried chicken tenders you've ever laid eyes on.
Shit.
Oh, I'm so hungry. And besides, sometimes unexpected combinations have a surprising effects that surpass their individual efforts.
Oh.
Are you suggesting if we combine forces, we can form the perfect food union?
Oh, yes. Time's up, students.
With time expired, it's the moment everyone has been waiting for.
You must now prepare to present your dishes.
A handful of students stand tall, but the class seems incomplete.
Seems we're missing some students. Pop. Clank.
From our screen, you hear a pure, innocent giggle that can only come from one student.
Yeah, I'm flying! Sounds like it's coming from the broom closet over there.
Miriam, would you mind?
Inside the closet, you see Pop hanging on a broom hook by the elastic of his underpants. Oh.
Pop, get down from there right now.
Let me guess, did Van Van have something to do with this?
When someone asks for a wedgie, who am I to refuse?
I thought a wedgie was a salad.
It looks like Pop isn't eliminated from the challenge, seeing how he didn't cook anything.
I can't feel my legs. May I be excused?
Sure. You kids and your pranks. I must say, it's not the worst prank in UCSAL history, but it's not exactly yearbook material. Wait a second. Pranks. Pranks. Clanks! Where did the pressure cooker roll off to?
You wait to hear a signature word beep and other onomatopoeia, but there is none.
Oh, because Van Van killed him.
Yeah.
Somehow he must have gotten unplugged. I guess we'll have to figure that one out later. That leaves only 4 remaining students. Please collect your final projects. Yes, it has been a long 3-day semester.
Yes, 3 whole days long.
But after days of hard work, the time has come for me to eat. Miriam, please step forward. Now describe your dish. I've made tender udon noodles in savory soup. My word, it's so delicate. Is that a teeny tiny Naritokamaki? I spy afloat in this itsy bitsy bowl. Yes, chef! Please call me Sprinkles. Chef is my father's name. Yes, Sprinkles, and some green tea made from baby tea leaves that I picked myself.
Sprinkles carefully sniffs around the dish just before opening his mouth and letting just the tip of his pink tongue dip into the bowl.
Sublime. Would anyone else like a taste? Oh, come on. I'm not one of those dogs who doesn't floss. I even have a really cute electric toothbrush for dogs. Fine. I'll enjoy it all by myself.
And in a flash, the entire meal has been devoured. Not that it took much. It was less than a thimble's worth of soup.
Aww. Oh, plus, rarely do I taste a dish with so much love poured into it as yours.
Miriam is overjoyed. She gives you a huge hug.
Thank you, Williams, for helping me believe in myself. Van Van, you're up. Now describe your dish.
I made uni over smooth egg custard in an Axune urchin shell topped with caviar.
Did you skewer one type of urchin with spines from a second different coloured type of urchin?
Yes, Sprinkles.
A bit much, don't you think?
That's exactly why I did it. A bit much is kind of my brand. Doesn't it look cool? Sprinkles leans in to sniff the uni, but he can't get his nose close on account of all the spice. He begins to pour at it erratically, causing the custard to slosh around.
Woof! Woof!
Please be gentle with my cuisine! Finally, Sprinkles goes all in, tongue first, but he can't get past all the needles. He reels back as his tongue is poked and prodded.
Ouch! My tongue!
The professor appears to be having an allergic reaction to the sting.
Oh no! I can't eat this. Is this perfect by itself? This horrified.
No. A stunning turn of events. Who would have thought that serving food in a bowl made of needles would make it difficult to eat?
Goodness.
Dejected Van Van does not go gentle into the night.
Disqualified for glamour?
Don't discount simplicity.
This isn't the last you've heard of me.
Before forcing us to endure his swirling tongue for another moment, Sprinkles graciously laps up a bowl of milk.
I know. Yes, I'm a dog, and I drink milk. Get over it. Sometimes it helps calm my agitated tongue. Next student, chalet, it's time to step up. Now describe your dish. I made orange blossom Turkish delight in a light rose water syrup, topped with French meringue.
Meringue,
thank you. French meringue and connected by sugar glass. Actually, just quite, that looks pretty impressive.
Yeah.
That actually doesn't sound too bad. Indeed, it's quite delightful. However, I ask that you please refrain from eating it or attempting to taste it. Anyway, it's very fragile and meant to be a display piece.
Don't eat the food and a cooking score.
Get toast in your ears or something, Williams. I told you, it's a display piece. Chalet, I must say, it is beautiful. However, this is a cooking competition at a cooking school. Yes, which is why I cooked it and did an extremely good job cooking it too. I didn't realize that we were having an eating exam. If I wanted to be judged on eating, I'd go to a college of eating school for the hungry. Dot, dot, dot. I suppose you could smell it if you absolutely insisted, but don't breathe too hard. You might disrupt the sugar spiral. If the food cannot be eaten, it cannot be judged. You are disqualified.
Wrecked. Rage takes over Ashley, and she finally cannot keep her two-faced routine up.
Oh. You wouldn't know high-end cuisine if it cooked you!
And with that, Ashley stormed off to rededicate herself to being the best. But this time, without being shackled by trying to be fake nice like and liked by everyone.
With a fucking butcher knife.
Yeah.
This isn't the last you've heard of me either! If this class gets much smaller, I'll be teaching myself.
You and Colonel Sanders, the final cook, step up together.
Two chefs?
What began as a bowl of delicious mac and cheese
has
become something else.
Oh.
He examines it closely, sniffing and eyeing the bowl.
That looks fucking heaven. It's just fried chicken and mac and cheese.
Yeah, it looks very brown.
I want it in my belly.
I love brown
food. So, yeah.
Uh-oh, I don't have a good feeling about this. From somewhere in the room, a literal drum roll plays.
Huh? Just when I thought I've seen everything in this kitchen, you give me this thing, and completely blow me away. In my 49 dog years of life, I have never tasted anything so deliciously and perfectly balanced. It's so delicious, the fact that everyone passes the class. You pass, you pass, you pass, you get a pass.
Everyone gathers around and partakes in the mac and cheese bowl. They all seem to transcend this reality into another dimension. You win!
Yay!
Together, you and Colonel Sanders have made a new menu item.
Hot damn.
New menu item is so impressive that even Van Van and Ashley are drawn back by its magnetic fragrance.
Wow.
When they gaze upon your mac and cheese bowl, they admit that you are indeed an excellent chef.
Everybody's crying.
Sprinkles declares that you have passed. Everyone has passed, and there were supposed to be more battles, but come on. How could they do better than this one?
I agree. Chicken and pasta is the best.
Exactly. Now that the school year is complete and everyone has graduated, the students return for one last assignment to get their groove on.
There's a prom?
The cafeteria has been completely redecorated and ordered to serve as a site of the school graduation dance.
Damn.
Compared to the massive high-tech cooking arena, the humble decor seems downright cute and cozy.
Oh, they put some curtains down. Ah, DJ Dog in the house. Oh, house.
You knew that Sprinkles was a master chef, but also a world-renowned turntablist? Who says you can't teach an old dog new tricks?
This bitch. Oh, new outfits!
Outfit
oh my
change.
God!
Van and Ashley tell everyone that they've committed themselves to righting the wrongs they did while they were the villains.
Doubtful.
They're smiling now. For a moment, you actually believe them. Not another haunting.
No ghosts allowed at graduation. It's clearly written in the school's bylaws.
I was never actually a ghost. It was all a trick to get you to finally notice me.
Oh, amusing.
And now that everyone is together... It's a spork monster, and he's totally mellowed out.
Everyone, the spork monster is no more. From here out, I'd prefer that everyone refer to me by my new name. Party monster!
Student tries to finish what he has to say, but everyone is too wrapped up talking to Spork. I mean, party monster. Dejected, the student walks off. Maybe things didn't work out for Miriam romantically, but she found the love in her cooking. And you know she's gonna do great.
Her outfit's adorable too.
Red carpet rolls across the floor of the ballroom like a Hollywood movie. Premiere. Who commands such an entrance?
Oh, we know. It's our boy. Oh, never mind.
Oh. It's Pop. He's arrived late to the dance, but apparently for a good reason.
Whoa, he's got a crown on his head.
Yeah. Walking the carpet, you see perched atop his head, his dirty chef's hat. A crown?
Welcome back, Pop. I know you weren't able to complete the final exam and accept your diploma, so we had it mailed directly to your father. We figured it was the least we could do for the school's dean.
Oh, now I get it.
And we got a new wing of the school, not to mention on of educating the son of the Chancellor of such and such.
Such and such. The music at the dance is interrupted by the sound of sparking and electrical hissing.
Oh.
It's Hanky's back. He's arrived late to the dance.
And he's got a little bow.
He's got two. He's got one on his hat as well.
Oh, damn.
Now that I have graduated, I can reveal my truth.
Whoa, he's still doing the talking thing.
Oh, no.
I am Clank, and I am not of this earth. I am actually from a faraway planet in another dimension.
Aliens?
What?
What?
I actually feel like I knew this the whole time.
Now that I've learned the ways of your kind, I must return. Miriam, will you come with me?
I don't know what to say. Besides, no, obviously. I have just begun to learn who I am. This isn't the time for me to devote my life to figuring out who you are, Clank.
Oh, you're blown away by Miriam's maturity. It's pretty clear she's managed to surpass you in that regard.
Well, you know.
I understand, kind of. Humans are weird.
Oh, he's so sad.
He is.
Oh, no.
A portal opens up and Clank disappears through it.
Oh, there we go.
Colonel Sanders arrives.
The pink petals are here.
Oh.
Is it a t-shirt? Oh.
Howdy, classmates. Just like the first day you met him, he's come prepared to feed the entire class. However, it's not enough to just give them a bucket of chicken. This time it's a full meal.
Whoa.
I didn't get to be the most famous chicken man in the history of chicken and man by not reminding people to go out and buy my chicken.
Damn. He's got the mash, he's got our coleslaw, he's got our scones.
He has got our coleslaw, that fucker.
Oh.
He's got them all. The end?
Question mark?
Wait, I want to have sex with the colonel. What the fuck? Oh, it's not the end. Everyone feasts on their delicious chicken dinner. Colonel Sanders finds you sitting at the edge of the dance floor. I like how they just had that little bit to like, buy my chicken.
Buy my chicken, you remember? KFC.
Well, I can't because the game's been going on too long and now it's closed. So.
Is it?
Well, the one near me is.
No!
Brilliant. Sorry, go on.
No, I was just like, oh, I still want some chicken though.
Yeah, make Jake go and get some.
Yeah, we'll do. Don't you worry.
Yeah. Williams, what are you doing sitting here all alone?
I'm being sad about not eating chicken.
Yeah, I know. Oh, you know, just waiting for the right person to ask me to dance.
Oh, smooth.
I wonder, might you tell me, what are the qualities that you expect to find in such a lucky person? He's sweating.
He's sweating.
Off the top of my head, oh, I don't know, a spicy musk, a tidy goatee, and a degree from the University of Cooking School Academy for Learning, just to name a few. It truly is my lucky day. Like, sometimes it says Colonel Sander, and sometimes it says Colonel Sanders.
Does.
Would you dance with me?
Yes, I would love to.
As you glide across the dance floor, hand in hand with Colonel Sanders, the future stretches out in front of you.
Oh.
And once my 100th franchise is up and running, I'll be ready to take a day off. And I'll be so glad to spend it together with you, Williams.
So, in like 20 years? Cool.
Yeah, fucking hell.
How sweet. We'll work together and play together.
Colonel Sanders stops dead in his tracks. Work together? Well, I think this is something I'll just need to do by myself.
What?
But who will help you run your restaurants?
I don't believe I need help. Besides, based on your time at school here, do you think really running restaurants is the best path forward? Could it be you found a love connection but failed to earn Colonel Sanders' respect as a chef? Can you live with only half of him? Will you be able to endure sharing him with his other love? The life of as an entrepreneur.
I suppose I could enroll in pastry school.
Oh, my dear Williams, I'm sure that you'll find your place eventually. Wow. Just like real life. Fucking hell.
That hurt deep.
And along the way, you'll have me by your side. The... And where's all the dirty shit?
There isn't any. It's a cute, sweet little KFC game.
What? I wanted to part his buns. Oh, it's going to be really loud, isn't it?
Ooh. Yeah.
And that's it. It's over. Oh, shit. Oh, it's so loud.
Wait, let me skip it. Ah, there we go. Cool. Yeah, it's over. That's it.
I enjoyed that thoroughly, but I was kind of hoping that I'd get to, like, stick my drumstick down the throat, you know?
Well, now that I have tipped your toe into a safe game, I could take you down a darker alley next time.
Oh, yes. Next Valentine, we'll have to... go into some horrific sort of smutty bullshit.
I've got some hentai games I could show you, my friend.
Oh, yes. Excellent. Get all hot and bothered together. Oh,
yes. I can't wait.
Although we probably won't be able to put them on YouTube. I'd have to...
You'd join us on Patreon.
Yeah, true. Patreon will be uncensored and fully fledged.
Titties akimbo.
Titties akimbo. I can't wait. No, that was a lovely... chickeny love journey.
I know, and I'm ready to eat some chicken, and I hope you are too. And I think we got finger licking good at the game.
I think we did too. We only failed once. So
yeah, you know.
I'll take it. But no, that was good fun. And we hope to see you in some more episodes next time.
Yeah.
We'll catch you guys soon.
Bye.
Bye.